there's nothing like a good old walk. It releases those inner tensions and in exchange allows you to absorb those feelings of tranquility that this beautiful planet offers so very well. In this series, I'm walking the length and the breadth of Norfolk, a trail taking me around 240 miles of the county's lanes. There's always something new to see, always a different view to capture, and in some ways, that makes exploring my home county a novelty. Every time. Starting up in Hunstanton, I walked along the Norfolk Coast Path to Cromer, took the Paston Way to North Walsham, the Weaver's Way to Elsham, and in this programme, join me as I follow the Marriott's Way. I'll be seeking out the obvious and teasing out the unfamiliar, but most importantly, I'll be walking parts of Norfolk that you can't take your car. Enough reason, if any, to park up, get out of your car, and start walking. Marriott's Way is a 26-mile footpath, bridleway and cycle route which follows the routes of two disused railway lines. Most of the country's railway tracks were laid during the railway mania of the mid-19th century, with Norfolk being connected in the 1890s. Marriott's Way is named after William Marriott, who was chief engineer of the Midland and Great Northern Railway for over 40 years. Marriott's Way really does offer something special to anyone who pays a visit. The landscapes it passes through are rich in flora and fauna. Spotting birds, animals and plants is easy. And if you're lucky, you might even spot the odd otter or kingfisher. Last time, we completed the Weaver's Way in Elsham, one of the most popular market towns in Norfolk, and it's where we begin our walk along the Marriott's Way today. This is Corston, a large village and one that can boast to having many historic places of interest, including Blickling Hall. Thank you.
Boston has changed dramatically in the last 50 to 100 years, just like everywhere else in Norfolk, with shop closures and pub closures. But the town still has a lot to offer.
And if you like Austin, then perhaps my next location along this walk will tick the box too. Reefham is a typical Norfolk market town, set within the picturesque countryside in the Wensum and Bure valleys. The King's Arms is thought to be 16th century and formerly a coaching inn. Although quite a lot of the town was destroyed in a fire, the rebuilding took place after that, which is why many of the pretty street alleys look relatively recent.
Although the buildings don't seem to last, the traditions do. The market, for instance, dates back to 1377. At the moment, it's held on a Wednesday. Today just had to be Tuesday, didn't it?
Three churches used to stand in a churchyard here. The Great Fire of 1543 destroyed one, leaving just a few fragments. St Mary's is now the single parish church and stands back to back with St Michael's. The interior was lovingly restored in the 19th century, and despite the fire, a few medieval treasures have survived. A local myth tells the tale that three sisters were responsible for the building of the three churches, which is why if you look at the town sign, the design shows a group of three churches with these three sisters.
It almost reminds me of the three weird sisters in Macbeth, which is a nice little link to my next stop, Lenwade. Lenwade is a hamlet. See what I did there?
Nestled within the Wensum Valley, Lenwade gives over much of its land to agriculture, but it hasn't always had a farming history. Lenwade became the centre of the sand and gravel extraction and the manufacturing of concrete products during the 1900s. And although the industry has died out here now, flooded gravel pits in the area leave a legacy.
Not only that, but naturalists, bird watchers and anglers love these mature lakes.
Local tourist attractions include a replica dinosaur park, and the Lenwade Country House Hotel features in its ground the only licensed zoological garden in the United Kingdom. The Marriott's Way at first glance from the map looks just like another trail in a county of walking routes and bridleways. But spend a couple of hours here, follow the Norfolk story, and you will get to know a county you thought you knew. Join me in the next programme as I continue my walk in search of Norfolk and amble along the Wensum Way.